building and the industry's success. Recent years have seen enormous strides in herd health, but what's next?
I'm now quite confident that the target set for 2020 will be met, and also the fact that from farm to fork, given that we have processors and retailers working closely with us, and government, of course, on side, it's all made a big difference in taking full responsibility for our actions and also owning some of the issues we have and then working on improving them.
Looking to the future, what will be different?
As we move beyond the 2020 targets, it's really important that in the next phase that we don't compromise animal welfare in any way in the work that we do, and we also need to have a more holistic view of this area. It's also very important that we base all our work on science, sound science, and this isn't in any way a case of winding back the clock on agriculture. I'm confident that the industry will, with supply chain, with government, farmers, vets, all work together in order to agree where we go in the next 4 or 5 years and deliver on that.
Vet, Richard Pearson.
Getting access to good, reliable data has allowed us to have those honest discussions with farms and say, look, this is where we are in terms of antibiotic use, this is where we are in terms of health management, is this where we want to be? And it's also allowed us to benchmark that usage. The other crucial thing that I think has then come out of that has been there's been a real sea change, a real shift in mindset and momentum in the pig sector, where people have really embraced the issue, sat up and said, we're going to engage with this, we know there's an issue, and we're going to do something about it. And that's been absolutely stupendous.
Dairy farmer Paul Tompkins.
Looking ahead, the eradication of diseases from my herd, such as yonies and BVD, means that naturally medicine usage is also going to fall as well.
And how do you do that?
Engaging industry programmes and working with my vet to reduce disease on farm means that in turn my cows will become happier and healthier, and of course then use less medicine as well. It's a win all round.
Prevention is always better than cure. Calf rearer Hannah knows buildings play a big part in herd health.
The buildings on our farm play an important part in herd health and management. We have a very high-tech system where we try and take huge advantage of technology out there, where I can control the temperature, there are heat exchangers in the buildings. I can adjust the ventilation system to give the right amount of air for a number of animals in the shed, and it removes all the stale air there to reduce the disease risk and to help prevent pneumonia.
From arrival on farm, the animal's health is a priority.
The dairy farmer again vaccinating on farm before they get to us, because by that point when they come to us, it's all mixed sources, they're more likely to catch something, it's like fresh as flu. On arrival, calves receive electrolytes in their water lines in the pens, so that helps again to reduce scarring, the diarrhea that you might see on farm.
Animal health, like human health, is fundamental. There's no room for compromise or second best. Simply put, healthy animals are an asset on any farm. Building on success.